legislation to avoid a rail strike. Let's watch.
Still have more work to do, in my view, in terms of ultimately getting paid sick leave, not just for rail workers, but for every worker in America. That is a goal I had in the beginning, and I'm coming back at it. But good morning. The bill I'm about to sign ends a difficult rail dispute and helps our nation avoid what, without a doubt, would have been an economic catastrophe at a very bad time in the calendar. Our nation's rail system is literally the backbone of our supply chain, as you all well know, and so much of what we rely on is delivered on our rail, from clean water to food and gas and every other good. Rail shutdown would have devastated our economy. Without freight rail, many of the U.S. industries would literally shut down. In the event of a shutdown, my economic advisors report that as many as 765,000 Americans, many of them union members themselves, would have been put out of work for the first time, and excuse me, within the first 2 weeks of the strike alone. Communities could have lost access to chemicals necessary to ensure clean drinking water. Farms and ranches across the country would have been unable to feed their livestock. And thanks to the bill Congress passed and one I'm about to sign, we've spared the country that catastrophe. At the same time, we ensured workers are going to get a historic 24% wage increase over the next 5 years, improved working conditions, and peace of mind around their health care. And look, I know this bill doesn't have paid sick leave that these rail workers and, frankly, every worker in America deserves. But that fight isn't over. I didn't commit we were going to stop just because we couldn't get it in this bill that we were going to stop fighting for it. I've supported paid sick leave for a long time. I'm going to continue that fight till we succeed. And I want to thank Congress, Democrats and Republicans, for acting so quickly. I know this was a tough vote for members of both parties. It was a tough for me, but it was the right thing to do at the moment. To save jobs, to protect millions of working families from harm and disruption, and to keep supply chains stable around the holidays, and to continue the progress we've made and we continue to see on the economy. For months, you couldn't look anywhere without seeing headlines screaming gas prices at the pump are up. But look, folks, gas prices are down, and you barely hear anything about it right now. They're continuing to go down, and there's a lot more that's going to happen. They're down more than $1.50 a gallon since the summer, and they continue to fall. And our economy continues to grow. The economic report, the GDP is up even more than it was previously thought. We continue to create jobs, lots of jobs. And today, we've learned that the economy added 263,000 jobs in November. Now, we've now created 10.5 million jobs since I took office, more than any administration in history at this point in the presidency. And 750,000 of them are domestic manufacturing jobs made in America. Unemployment rate remains near an all-time 50-year low, 3.7%. And wages for working families, I want to say this again, wages for working families, in fact, over the last couple months have gone up. These wage increases are larger than the increase in inflation during that same period of time. And so we're in a position now where things are moving. They're moving in the right direction. As we go into the holiday season, here's what this all means. The Americans are working. The economy is growing. Wages are rising faster than inflation. And we've avoided a catastrophic rail strike. It means our plan to build the economy from the bottom up and the middle out. You're tired of hearing me say that, but it's working. And the wealthy are still doing very well, while the middle class and the poor are having a shot. I want to thank Congress once again for being partners today, for averting this disaster and keeping our economy on a stable footing during the holiday season. I want to thank you all, and I'm going to reach over here and sign this bill and make it official. This is the House Joint Resolution 100. Okay. And by the way, I really can't emphasize enough how much I appreciate the team behind me working with business and labor to get this done and avoid this, what otherwise is a really good bill lacking only one thing. And we're going to get that one thing done before it's all over. But anyway, Thank you.
Mr. President, why are you going to Georgia to help Senator Warnock?
I'm going to Georgia today to help Senator Warren, not to Georgia. I'm going to help Senator Warren because I'm doing a major fundraiser up in Boston.
Thank you, Mr.
Today for our next and continued Senate candidate. Senator.
Mr. President, how soon should rail workers expect sick days?
To buy oil and refill the strategic reserves, Mr. President?
As soon as I can convince our Republicans to see the light.
And is it time for the U.S. government to step in to prevent the spread of hate speech?
Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you.
All right, so there you have President Biden signing a measure that would essentially block the railway workers from striking, forcing them to agree to a previously agreed or previously negotiated package that the White House was able to hammer out, but a number of unions did not agree.